Hello everyone and welcome to the Picture Education. In this particular video, we are going to talk about the physiological buffers and the condition associated with it like acidosis and alkalosis. So what are physiological buffers? So the buffer which are present inside the organism like us human beings or any other kind of animal are known as physiological buffers. So they help in maintaining equilibrium in our system. So from our previous discussion, we know that the buffer help in maintaining the pH. So buffer are present both in intracellular fluid and extracellular fluid. So in intracellular fluid, the phosphate buffer system are the most prominent one, while in extracellular fluid, the carbonic acid bicarbonate buffer is the prominent one. And in between comes the protein buffer system, which help in maintaining both intracellular pH and extracellular pH. So in protein buffer system, hemoglobin buffer system is present for intracellular pH control, and plasma proteins are there for extracellular pH control. And again, there's come amino acid buffer system, which are present both intracellularly and extracellularly for the maintenance of pH. So now let's talk about the carbonic acid bicarbonate buffer. So there in our system, there is an equilibrium established. So the water reacts with the carbon dioxide to form carbonic acid, so which further dissociated into the proton moiety and the bicarbonate ion with the help of carbonic anhydrase. So any fluctuation in pH in blood plasma are controlled by this buffer system. So it is a major buffer in blood, and the pH of blood is 7.4, which is at higher upper limit or which is slightly basic. It is because many metabolic activity generates acid, so the slightly basic pH help in neutralizing those acid. So what happens when pH fluctuates in our system? So there are medical conditions associated with pH, namely acidosis and alkalosis. So in alkalosis, the blood pH increases or the blood pH becomes more of basic, and in acidosis, the blood pH decreases or it becomes acidic. But in normal condition, there is equilibrium established. So water reacts with carbon dioxide to form carbonic acid, which further dissociates into the proton moiety and the bicarbonate moiety. But when these conditions are disturbed, they generate these medical conditions like alkalosis and acidosis, and too much fluctuation in this equilibrium can result in death. So now let's talk about the alkalosis. So now coming to alkalosis, it is characterized by increase in blood pH. The blood become more basic or alkaline, and the alkalosis can occur due to the two following reasons. It can be due to the respiratory alkalosis or it can be due to the metabolic alkalosis. So in respiratory alkalosis, the breathing rate is rapid than normal and there is a more carbon dioxide elimination. So if carbon dioxide is present in blood, it makes the blood pH acidic. So equilibrium is important, and removal of the more of the carbon dioxide result in alkalosis, and the equilibrium of the system shift to the right. And coming to the metabolic acidosis, it occurs due to the elevated or the high concentration of the bicarbonate ion, or it can be due to the loss of the proton moieties. So it can occur due to the generation of more of the basic moieties during the metabolic activities, and it can be due to the addition of bicarbonate ion and loss of fluid that have low concentration of bicarbonate, and due to the loss of hydrogen as we talked about. So let's come to acidosis. So it is characterized by decrease in blood pH. Here's the equilibrium shift to the left. Again, acidosis can occur due to the two main reasons. It can be either due to the respiratory acidosis and it can be due to the metabolic acidosis. So in the metabolic acidosis, it is caused by the generation of a proton due to the metabolic activities. But other conditions are also there, like uncontrolled diabetes, starvation diet, high protein or low fat diets, overproduction of acidic compound like ketone bodies, which lowers the blood pH. Or during exercise, there is a formation of lactic acid. But sudden surges in lactic acid can also cause the metabolic acidosis. Now coming to the respiratory acidosis, it can occur due to the hypoventilation. Here there is a less removal of carbon dioxide. So in respiratory alkalosis, there is a excess removal of the carbon dioxide, but in the respiratory acidosis, there is a less removal of carbon dioxide. So if the carbon dioxide is present, there is a formation of the more of the proton moiety, so the blood pH decreases. So how the acidosis or alkalosis being maintained? like we talked about, the buffer system help in maintaining the pH. For the intercellular, we have a hemoglobin buffer system. So what it do is, it transport oxygen from lungs to peripheral tissue, and in the peripheral tissue, the respiration occur. So what hemoglobin do is, it take carbon dioxide from tissues to lungs for exhalation. Hemoglobin is a buffer for both carbon dioxide and proton moiety. So the carbon dioxide can bind directly with the hemoglobin and release in lungs, and carbon dioxide can react with the water that form carbonic acid, which dissociate into bicarbonate in RBCs. So here is the example. The hemoglobin take oxygen from the lungs and give it to the tissue. So in tissue, the respiration occur and the carbon dioxide is released, which can directly bind with the hemoglobin, or carbon dioxide can be directly dissolved in the plasma, or it can be make a compound with the water, which form bicarbonic acid, and the carbonic acid dissociated into the proton moiety and the bicarbonic acid. So the proton binds to hemoglobin, and also the protein can directly bind to the hemoglobin to make the protein, the proton hemoglobin moiety. And the proton bind to hemoglobin and release in RBC in lung to combine with the bicarbonate and reform carbon dioxide for exhalation. And there is a phosphoric acid species which are present intracellularly, which also help in maintaining the pH. And protein groups are there because they have ionizing group which help in buffering. And in kidney, there is a ammonia buffer system. So there occurs a tubular deamination of glutamine, which generates ammonia, which is transported into tubule and buffers. So the proton moiety get attached to the ammonia, and they generate ammonium ion, and which is transported into the urinary space, and this is how like the buffer system works in kidney. So the short-term maintenance are done by hemoglobin or the carbonic acid buffer system, but the long-term maintenance are done by kidneys. Also, in the short-term maintenance, the excessive breathing or the hypoventilation can also be help in the maintaining the acidosis or alkalosis. So I hope you like this video. If you like, please stay tuned in for the more videos, and thank you for your patient listening.